Hi, everyone. My name is Faye Harms, and I'd like to welcome all of you to the Dale Evans Happy Hour. On behalf of supporter students, I thank you so much for coming today. 100% of the money and all items received today will go directly to disadvantaged children of all grade levels. I think we take things for granted sometimes because we can go buy whatever we want, whenever we want it at any time. Unfortunately, these kids can't. So once again, thank you all for your generosity. Remember the 50s? Don't lie, I think you all do. It was a time when our grandkids referred to as the dark ages, or the olden days. We have some pretty good memories of that decade. It was a whole different world back then, wasn't it? It was a time when things we bought actually lasted. We used to hope something would break down so we could get a new one. No problem with that happening today. Our appliances have lasted 25, 30 years or more. Now today we think it's great if they last 5 or 6. We had one, maybe 2 pair of shoes, one for every day and one for church, one dress for church, and several dresses for school. We couldn't wear pants to school unless it was cold outside, and then we had to wear them under our dresses. Our family ate 3 meals together, not when it was convenient because of our schedules. We didn't have a schedule. We didn't eat between meals either. We didn't have pop and chips or crackers or candy in the house unless it was a special occasion like Christmas or Easter. Our parents told us we could not drink coffee or tea because it would stunt our growth. Well, that must have been true, because I grew to be 5'10". The only thing we heard about athletes was what we read on the back of the Wheaties box. If someone was fortunate enough to have a camera and take a picture, you had to wait until the whole film was used up before you could have it developed. It took you so long. You had a hard time remembering why you took it or where you were. We didn't each have a phone. We had one phone in the house. It hung on the wall and had a long, curly cord. We dangled the receiver and let it spin until it untangled itself. When we heard 2 short and 2 long rings, we knew it was for us. When you wanted to make a call, you had to put your finger in a little hole and turn the dial. A number like 909-8899 could take some time. And if a phone call wasn't for you, you could still pick it up and listen to what the neighbors were saying. And that was the beginning of Facebook. How about the prank calls we used to make? Like calling someone and asking them if their refrigerator was running. Then we'd say, well, you better go catch it. One of my favorites was, do you have Prince Albert in the can? And we would say, well, you better let him out. You get the idea. It was all in fun and no one got hurt. There was no such thing as caller ID, so no one knew who was calling. Later in the 70s, though, when answering machines were invented, most of us didn't like them because we didn't like talking to a machine. Now it seems like that's all we do. People just don't talk to each other as much anymore. As we progressed out of the 50s and 60s, some things got easier, but in a way, harder. You have a zillion choices to make in what you buy, but customer service sometimes really sucks. Medical advances and drugs can extend your life, but many people can't afford them. We didn't own a TV until later in the 50s. I loved watching Gunsmoke, Sky King, Rin Tin Tin, Captain Kangaroo, and the Roy Rogers Show. I have a friend who loved that show so much, she blew kisses at the TV screen when it was over. When I talked to Priscilla about doing something like this, I asked her if she knew who Dale Evans or Roy Rogers were. Guess what? She didn't have a clue. That's why I think it's fun to do something like this, because no matter what the time frame, there are certain people that stand out and are remembered for one thing or another. We have several models, role models in today's sports world. Dale Evans was a role model, being known as Queen of the Cowgirls. She is quoted in saying, "Cowgirl is an attitude, really, a pioneer spirit, a special American brand of courage. The cowgirl faces life head on, lives by her own lights, and makes no excuses. Cowgirls take stands. They speak up. They defend the things they hold dear." We're going to take you back to the interesting life of Dale Evans. I'll go get her while Bart and Jerry entertain you with singing some old cowboy songs.
Provided by yourselves, because you want you to sing along, and the screen will actually help you do so, old karaoke style. So feel free, give it all you got.
Okay,
well,
I'm today's a good night. It's nice outside.
It was actually pretty nice outside. I know some of you, where you from? Probably not too good. So you meant you're going to be in Arizona. Out in the desert!
Yeah.
Old Tucson.
Old Tucson.
Old water. You ready? All right. And off we go. It's my daughter back there, Marie. She's been running my sound and doing all kinds of stuff for years. Our first song is Home on the Range. The words are on the screen.
I don't know.
Sing along. This is Priscilla's sing along.
You can see it from there.
Home on the Range. give me a land where the bright lights and sand flows leisurely down the stream, where a graceful white swan flows gliding along like a maid in a heavenly stream.
All right, let's hear you now.
All go out to meet her, yes, we'll all
Now this is the way to cheer this up.
Yeah.
So, you know, do you mind one of these songs that we do?
Feel the sub urge to get up and do a line dance or do some song?
Help yourself. Enjoy.
Entertain us.
There you go.
We'll get our choo-choo
tape. This one is slow. From this valley, they say, you are going. We will miss your dry eyes and sweet smile. For they say, you are taking the sun. This one is slow dance, you know. Tom.
I think Faye took my glasses.
Never apart. Retire his best. He said.